Hi, I'm Kevin McCabe, a senior application engineer at IDS Imaging. And today I'm going to help you get started with the Peak sample source code, this time on Linux. Now, when you initially test a camera, you'll use Peak Cockpit, and you can adjust all the camera parameters, save some data out like images or video, and you can even evaluate the performance of a target system. After testing the camera's imaging performance, the next step is to evaluate how the camera can integrate into your own software application. Our Peak manual has a progressive guide to all of the fundamental software operations you'll need to complete with the camera. Each page has a growing code example at the bottom. Additionally, each library, the generic API, the IPL, the AFL, and the Comfort API have their own dedicated documentation, which you can freely reference. But sometimes you want a lot of this initial setup work done for you, and that's where the Peak sample programs come in. Under the install directory, you'll find examples that show general operation of the camera, as well as demo-specific functionality. You can find a description of each of these samples in the manual. We'll be setting up tools for each programming language supported by the Peak API, and I'll go over how to install all of these tools in their specific sections. As we get started, I do have a recommendation. I would copy the folder containing the libraries and the sample source code from the install directory to a directory which your user has full permissions. This will help alleviate any permission space issue as we move forward.
You can perform this operation in the Linux terminal instead. Here are the commands to use.
Now let's get to it. Since we'll be using Visual Studio Code for each language this time around, let's install that before we split off to each individual section. On the Microsoft Visual Studio Code website, we can go to the Downloads page, and you'll see there's a section for Linux which has various installers for many different distributions of Linux. We are on Ubuntu, so we could use the .deb file, but this time we're actually going to use the Snap Store, and Ubuntu already has this Snap Store installed under the App Center. We'll go to the Snap Store here on the left-hand side, and we'll search for Visual Studio Code, and we'll get the latest stable release, and we'll install it. Now that we've installed Visual Studio Code, we can move on to the language-specific sections. Here are the timestamps for each of these sections. As we begin with Python, we'll install a virtual environment tool to allow us to install any package dependencies needed without affecting our system-wide Python installation. You can do this via the VS Code terminal, but in this case, we'll do it via the built-in Ubuntu terminal. Now back in Visual Studio Code, we'll install an extension for Python. We'll click Extensions on the left-hand side and install the main Python extension. And this is all we need to run our example scripts. Let's continue here by opening one of the folders that contains a Python project. We'll use Simple Live Cute Widgets here. We'll use the command panel, Control-Shift-P, to create a virtual environment and select our Python interpreter as the native version that we have installed for Ubuntu. Now, if we hit run here, we'll get complaints that we don't have the correct packages installed. So let's fix that. We'll use the built-in terminal in Visual Studio Code to run pip commands to install PySide 6 and IDS Peak packages. Now, even after we install the required packages, we're running into a problem here. It looks like something's happening with the Qt install. So we can do a little troubleshooting here. We'll use again the terminal in Visual Studio Code to set some environment variables to turn on debugging for the Qt libraries. And once we do that, we can see that it's pointing towards what looks to be a missing library. So let's install that library and see if it's an easy fix. And with that library installed, we're now up and running. We'll begin with C# by installing the latest .NET packages. Now, I strongly recommend going with the package that's managed by your distribution, and that's what we'll do here. You can use the official Microsoft script or VS Code itself, but I've had complications in the past regarding setting environment variables and programs still not recognizing that .NET is installed correctly. So let's have Ubuntu do the heavy work here and just use apt to install the package. Now in Visual Studio Code, we'll install the required extensions. We'll click on the left-hand side. And if we install the C# dev kit here, we will get all the extensions that we need to run the examples. Now let's open a project folder. In this case, we'll use a simple example, the open camera sample code. Visual Studio Code will do some processing in the background for us and create a bin and object folder and create a solution from the CS project file in the folder. You can see we have some problems here, but we'll address those a little bit later. An important thing to do here is let's adjust our target framework to the .NET version that we have installed, which is .NET 8.0 in this case. We'll attempt to build here, but we'll run into an error. You can see in the terminal, the platform property must not be set to any CPU. So let's try to work around this with the .NET command line interface. We use a build command and use the parameter platform equals x64. And now we can run this build with dash dash no build since we already built it. But there's still an error. It looks like by default, it's looking for the executable in the wrong directory. We can work around this by building again and specifying the output folder. And make sure you get the path correct. I got the path incorrect here, so we'll re-enter it. And now when we run with platform is x64, we get the program to run. For our C and C++ examples, we've included CMake files so you can choose your development environment, though we'll continue to use Visual Studio Code here. In addition, the development team focused on using a cross-platform framework called Qt, so the majority of our examples are useful for Linux users as well. This does mean we'll need to ensure we have Qt installed to use these examples, though. We'll choose an example that uses our ComfortC libraries. ComfortC provides a function call and return value style of programming for our cameras, and thus provides a simpler way to program with our cameras. As an example, in ComfortC, there is automatic buffer allocation when you start capturing frames from a camera. In the generic API, this would take about 10 lines versus 1 in ComfortC. We'll begin by installing the required extensions. And here, there's actually an extension pack that will include every extension that we need. So now let's open that ComfortC folder. Go to Documents, Peak Samples, IDSP ComfortC here. C, and finally, we'll choose Simple Live Qt Widgets. We'll trust the authors here. To compile, run, and debug our sample code here, we'll need a few software packages. We'll use GCC for our compiler, and also install a debugger, GDB. We'll check if GCC is installed, and it's not, so let's install Build Essential and GDB packages, as well as CMake. Next, we will run our CMake configure command. So we'll hit Control Shift P and search for CMake configure, run that, then choose GCC for our compiler, and CMake will do some configuration work in the background to set up our build. Now that we're all configured, we can click the CMake extension tab in the bottom left. And we'll click Build. And finally, we can click Run and Debug. And now we're up and running. I hope this look into getting started with the Peek sample source code will push you forward in your project. And for guidance on your next steps, I'd recommend watching the How to Use IDS Peek Machine Vision SDK video. And as always, you can reach out to our Machine Vision consulting team at any time for help. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you again soon on the IDS Vision channel.